smallest and very capable, cover it all, photography kit for your travel photography. Let's talk about this in this video now. Hi there, my name is Tudor Matescu and I like to talk on my channel about photography camera, photography gear, photography tips and tricks. And if you are liking content like this, please be sure to subscribe now to my channel, because I'll post more content like this. So let's get to the subject. My wife decided to visit her parents in the holidays and she took the train with my two kids and went to Cluj-Napoca. She took the night train with two kids with baggages. And she asked me to make her a kit for doing some pictures in her short holiday. So she asked me for Sony, but I said to her, I will not give you my Sony camera and the Tamron 28 to 55mm f2.8, because the camera, it is big and the files will be very big. It will be very cumbersome with luggages, with two kids, to carry such a beast of the camera with you. And I think to give her Fujifilm or a Micro Four Thirds camera. But on Fujifilm I don't have any zooms, because they are pretty big and I wanted a very small compact kit. So I've decided to give her Lumix GX9 with 12 to 45 Olympus F4 Pro Zoom and this small lens from Olympus, 17mm f1.8 lens. And I'm showing pictures, JPEG, straight from the camera pictures, done with Lumix GX9 and with these lenses. And we'll talk about why this kit, why these lenses, and how this kit overall acted in a holiday like this. And now let's look at some pictures done with this small lens from Olympus, 70mm f1.8. So, first of all, why I've decided to use the 17mm f1.8 lens and Lumix GX9? First of all, you can record videos and take pictures with Lumix GX9 in the same time. The IBIS, it is very good. She didn't record any videos, but if you want to do that, you can do that. And I've choose the 70mm f1.8 lens for low light photography, for indoor photography and for places with low light. And this lens, it is acting very good, but this lens has a manual focusing clutch, and if you don't know about it, it's possible to bump it. So unfortunately, when she got to a place where this lens was needed to be used, she bumped the manual focusing clutch and didn't know about it. And she tried to use manual focusing, but the pictures are acceptably clear. So anyway, I've choose this lens because at f1.8, it is very sharp. You can do portraits, but also it's a very good lens, how I've said, in tight spaces. So if she wanted to take pictures of her parents in the apartment, this was the go-to lens. And of course, the next lens was a zoom lens, because from my point of view, this is all you need to travel. Now let's look at some pictures done with this 12 to 45 f4 Pro Zoom. and the zoom lens, it's an F4 zoom lens that I love it for what it is. It's an Olympus F4 Pro zoom lens with an amazing contrast. I've bought this lens for street photography where I want to cover all the scenes, but this is also a very good zoom for travel photography. You have from the 24mm field of view in a full frame terms to the 19mm rich field of view. The zoom is very compact, and it's not just that, it is a very good quality zoom. It's having an amazing micro contrast, and I think you will be able to see this micro contrast even on a small smartphone screen, but also on the big screen. So I love this lens for what it is, and this is why I'm sorry that Panasonic will not make a new GX10 with a better sensor for photography. Check my video regarding this, link in the card here. So anyway, being summer, she didn't have any need for zooms and for lenses and for sensors that are capable in low light. This zoom is helping you get all the scene, but also it's helping you to get details, and it's also helping you to reach to the kids if the kids are playing in a place where you can't reach, So it's a very versatile zoom for travel photography, family photography, for documenting your holidays, Also, it's focusing very fast. Both lenses are focusing very fast, and both lenses are very quality lenses. And the colors from the Lumix GX9 are beautiful colors, in a way Leica colors, I would say, because as we know, Lumix is working with Leica, and they learned something from Leica. And the package, it is great. The files are ready to be printed and ready to be categorized on albums online or in printed albums. So this is huge. The past holiday, she used Sony A7S with the Tamron. But Sony A7S, it's a smaller camera, and the files were smaller than my Sony A7 R3. And I needed to edit those files. I needed to edit the Sony files. This is what I don't like regarding the Sony system. You really need to edit the files. But these files are ready to be shared, ready to be printed. You really don't need to make any adjustments. Just if you missed the exposure or just an auto exposure or auto correction in Lightroom on the JPEG files, and you are ready to go. So this is the travel kit. This is what I personally would take if I would travel, because it is very small and very capable. This small 70mm f1.8 lens, it's helping me to get the shots that I need to get in low light photography, to get portraits, to get documentary shots, and this is helping me to cover the whole day. When the night is coming, I will use the 70mm f1.8 from Olympus. Yes, in very low light situations, of course, I will follow the light, because photography, it's done in the end with light, and in good photography, light matters. But because we know that we have the option of better sensors, this is why personally I look at other systems, and I like to use other systems too. So thank you for watching this video. Please be sure to subscribe to my channel now, and if you are interested in buying some of the gear that I recommend and use, please be sure to check my affiliate links. This is helping me a lot. Share my video, like my video, leave me a comment, and talk to you soon. Bye bye.